Hi, this is Bob Stern again from Keysight Technologies. I'm the principal metrologist. I'd like to talk a little bit more now about what we're able to do in standards lab calibrations at our Roseville, California site. We're very proud of this service center. It's one of our largest. The Roseville site does calibrations for over 50 countries. First, I'd like to show you what we're doing in the area of power sensors. Power goes back to SI units by the amount of heat that it generates in a temperature bath, and that's the amount of power that's delivered. So that's a very accurate way to measure power. It's called a calorimeter, which is in Boulder, Colorado. This is NIST. What NIST does is they then calibrate a reference sensor, and then that sensor can be used to calibrate sensors which are sent in by outside customers. The top two rows here are what an NMI has with the calorimeter. Those really aren't commercially available. The one level which is available when you send it in to an NMI is going to take you about 8 to 12 weeks to get that sensor back. I'm going to show you what Keysight does in this Roseville lab, which is just one step removed from what you get from either NIST or another NMI. This is a resistor combiner, and you can see the reference sensor, which was calibrated by NPL, and then the sensor under test on the other side of the resistor combiner. This is how you get the very lowest measurement uncertainty. And let me show you how this all works out. The x-axis is frequency in gigahertz, and then on the left-hand side, what you see is the cal factor measurement uncertainty. The bottom curve is what you can get if you send a sensor to a National Institute of Metrology. If you get the H84 cal, you can get just slightly degraded, but also very, very good measurement uncertainty. Now, if you then use that same sensor to calibrate other sensors, the error goes up. Now, they have a number of different capabilities that they have in that lab. In the interest of time, I'm just going to show you one more. Attenuator calibration. The attenuator calibration system is inside of a shielded enclosure or Faraday cage. As you step through the door, you can see our dual attenuator cal systems. This room is completely shielded, and we're able to measure attenuators 0 to 120 dB without having to stop and measure individual steps. But we have enough dynamic range in this chamber that up to 4 gigahertz, we're able to look at attenuation with an incredible measurement uncertainty down to 120 dB attenuation directly. If you need attenuators calibrated absolutely accurately, I encourage you to consider using the Roseville Standards Lab for those measurements. Before I leave, I'd like to review the key deliverables that you'll receive regardless of which discipline we are operating in, both the calibration report and the calibration certificate. So let's just take a look here at the table. You can see the Keysight Standards Lab calibrations on the right-hand side. The first row, primary lab standards. What distinguishes these from our other calibrations is that we use either a primary standard or one step removed from a primary standard. That's where we get the really good accuracy and the really low measurement uncertainties. Moving down to measurement guard band, if the device you send in has a specification and part of the job is to check and see whether it passed or failed, we will apply an expanded measurement uncertainties guard band. However, if it is an item which requires only a characterization, such as a power sensor when you're looking at the calibration factor, then we simply provide the calibration factor and the uncertainty associated with that. You will receive always both the data that we measured and the measurement uncertainties, and because we are accredited in all of the parameters corresponding to these measurements, you will receive the accreditation body symbol. And then moving down into the standards compliance, the deliverables I've just indicated to you are what it takes to meet ISO 17025, and they also meet both of the Z540 standards, the old -1 and the new .3, as well as easily passing anything that's in ISO 9001. So from a standards compliance standpoint, you're very well covered. If any of the services that I have described look interesting to you, I encourage you to either contact your service representative from Keysight or contact one of our call centers, and we will be glad to look up whether we're able to take care of the device that you have. And if that looks good to you, we'd be happy to make a quotation. Thank you very much for listening.